Hello, my name is Vincent Gasnier. I'm the Master Sommelier at the NED. I'm going to talk you through this beautiful wine which I've put together for you for the August wine selection. Those wine selections have been quite popular over the last few months that we thought we'd carry on with a little service for you members. And I'm particularly excited about these six wines here because they are some of my latest discoveries and wines that are absolutely fantastic with food or even on their own. The first one is Pinot Bianco. I'm really excited about all the wine coming from Eastern Europe because they are, thanks to the cooler climate and the mountains and the vines are working much harder because of the lack of sunshine to dig very deep to get the nutrition and the minerals from the soil, and therefore those wines are always more expressive and more authentic in a way. This one is a wine from Slovenia. Don't be scared, it's probably my favorite one of the box. Why? Because when you look at Europe, countries such as Italy, this wine is actually on the other side of Veneto. So Veneto is the northeast of Italy. This wine here of Slovenia, the vines are planted just on the other side of the mountain, southeast facing to the sunshine, therefore making the microclimate even cooler. The wine is very expressive, it's dry, it's light, it's crisp, very similar to a Chablis style, thanks to the stone fruit flavors, pear, apple, a great minerality. And funny enough, the wine lingers so long that it's almost like never ends. So absolutely stunning. So Pinot Bianco from Slovenia. The next wine is one of my all favorite because I'm not a fan of Sauvignon Blanc. I tend to find them quite grassy. Well, this wine is made by the famous family called Antinori, where they produce the famous Tignanello and Sassicaia. And of course, these producers are very fan of Bordeaux style wine. Well, in Bordeaux, there's a white wine that is made from Sauvignon, but also Sémillon. So this wine comes from Umbria, so in the central part of Italy, but Umbria is famous for light, crisp wine. Quite actually boring, called Orvieto. Well, here is a very small production made from the same grape as Bordeaux, so one with quite juicy and zesty, so fresh. It always reminds me when I drink it of like having a cold orange or a cold clementino from the fridge, which makes your mouth all watery and juicy and stunning, absolutely stunning. I would serve it with even chicken or grilled fish or anything like this. So, a winner. They're all winners. But next wine is a wine from France. These guys are quite crazy. They own little vineyards because they've studied in California. They're French, but they came back to Burgundy to buy some little vineyards. So they don't own the land, but they own the grapes. And here they found a boutique winery just outside Châteauneuf-du-Pape in the Côte-du-Rhône vineyard. But the wine is organic, it's not filtered, it's just it's aged in oak barrels for a very short while. But the wine is tastes almost like honey, like mango, lots of exotic fruit. So a very complex wine, a wine that is definitely designed for food. And personally, I would serve it very cold, but then I would put it in a decanter just like a red wine, just to open up the flavors. The wine is outstanding and very rare. Moving on to the next wine, there's a wine from the Roussillon. So Roussillon is very famous for mass-produced wine. But here, this producer has only 4 hectares of vines. He produces only a quarter of the normal volume. So let's say that normally, usually that one region, they would produce around 50, 60 hectoliters per hectare. Here he only produces 12, which is crazy. But the main difference is that the vines here are produced on terraces, like an amphitheater. And therefore they have full exposition to the sunshine, allowing the grapes to grow very, very well. But there's a slight mistral, a slight cold wind that cools down the temperature. The particularity of this wine is 2015, so it's 5 years old, but still tastes so fresh and so almost fruity, lively. But here, what they do is that rather than making a wine which is quite extracted. When doing the fermentation, they plunge the skin back into the juice to make sure they extract the flavors and the color without extracting the tannins, which make this wine absolutely so suave and so delicious. So really good wine. A wine that I will even serve at a slight cooler temperature. I would advise to put this wine like half an hour in the fridge before serving it, just to make it a bit to enhance the fruit flavors inside the wine. Next, I thought it's quite fun because one of the very famous wine is Châteauneuf-du-Pape, as we all know. Well, Châteauneuf-du-Pape is an appellation contrôlée, just like London cannot be anywhere else than London. Well, Châteauneuf-du-Pape cannot be anywhere else than Châteauneuf-du-Pape. But this guy, Langmill, or passionate about the Southern Rhone wines, and you may have seen that in most in the South Hemisphere, you see sometimes on label SMG, which stands for Shiraz, Mourvèdre, and Grenache. So here is a blend of a third each from the heart of the Barossa Valley in Australia. So a wine quite big and opulent, but because the fermentation has been kept quite low temperature, the wine is not alcoholic, it's not jammy, it's just so well balanced, absolutely delicious. A wine that I would drink now, in fact. And then finally, one of these amazing gems, it's a wine made by Petrus, yes, Chateau Petrus, but in Napa Valley. And they've got this tiny vineyard called Otello, which is a wine that they've made a bit more fruit-driven, I would say, less intense and much less expensive, trust me. But quality-wise and value for money is outstanding. It's a wine you can't find in any supermarket or any that special. So it's called Otello. The wine is 2014, which was a great vintage in the Napa Valley. What makes this wine very special is that it comes from the southern part of the Napa Valley, where in the morning in that valley it's very foggy, which keeps the temperature very cool, very good for the acidity and the tannins for the grapes. But then the wind coming from that Bay of San Francisco blows away these fogs, and then the sunshine in the afternoon keeps the grapes dry and healthy, otherwise obviously they'd be rotting. So the slower is the ripening season, the more complex are your wines. And this is exactly what will happen here in this very special bottle of wine. Here are your six wines. We obviously have another case with 12 bottles, which are as exciting and as fascinating as these ones. But I look forward to seeing you very soon for my next wine selection. Santé.